Steph Curry's basketball resume is about as good as it gets. In addition to being generally considered the greatest shooter in basketball history, he's one of 8 players with 3 titles and multiple MVPs. Now, on this prestigious list, there's only 2 players who don't have an NBA Finals MVP, Bill Russell and Steph. In Russell's case, that's because the award wasn't introduced until 1969, his last year in the league. But what about Steph? In 5 trips to the finals, he's never won the trophy, which on face value is kind of shocking for a player of his stature. In fact, some may look at it as an indictment against his greatness. So that made me curious. Has Steph not played well enough to win the award? Or were there other narratives that got in his way? Let's take a look. Let's start with the 2015 finals, where the Warriors overcame the Cavaliers for the first title of the Splash Bros era. The reigning league MVP Steph Curry led the winning team in both points and assists, but didn't receive a single vote for finals MVP. Huh, why is that? Looking back, there were 3 narratives that seemed to get in his way. Number 1, LeBron James was a complete monster during that series. LeBron carried an injury-depleted Cavaliers squad all series, averaging 35 points, 13 rebounds, and 8 assists. I mean, the dude balled so hard. Even though his team lost, people thought he should have still won the finals MVP anyway. A feat which had only been accomplished by someone on the losing team once, when Jerry West coincidentally did it against Bill Russell's Celtics in 1969. The second narrative that got in Steph's way was his own teammate, Andre Iguodala, the surprise hero. Iguodala came off the bench for the first 3 games of the series and the Dubs fell behind 2-1. But after he was inserted into the starting lineup in Game 4, the Dubs didn't lose another game in the series. Iguodala finished the series with an average of 16 points, 4 assists, and 5 rebounds. Not really that crazy compared to what LeBron and Steph put up, but his defensive impact on LeBron caught everyone's attention. The difference between LeBron's production when Iguodala was on the court as opposed to off the court was massive. Basically, Iggy kept LeBron from averaging 80 points, and they gave him the trophy for his efforts. Iguodala became the first finals MVP to not start a single game during the regular season. The third and final narrative, and perhaps the most laughable, was the idea that scrappy Cavs backup Matthew Dellavedova was the Curry stopper. Curry averaged 26 points, 5 boards, and 6 dimes in the finals that year, shooting 44% from the field and 38% from downtown. Numbers that match up pretty closely to what he averaged during the regular season in 2015 when he won the MVP. I don't think Delly stopped him at all. In fact, I think a pretty solid case can be made that Curry should have won that 2015 Finals MVP because he was the best player on the winning team. Let's move on to the next year, 2016. This is the finals most known for the Warriors blowing a 3-1 advantage in the rematch with LeBron's Cavs. Steph averaged 22 points, almost 5 boards, and 3 dimes per game. Real pedestrian numbers for a guy of his stature, and to his credit, he never used the injuries as an excuse, taking his loss like a true competitor. So yeah, Steph definitely was not worthy of the 2016 Finals MVP, but there were some more chances to come in his future. Like the very next year in the 2017 NBA Finals. Now before I get into it, let's do a blind player comparison, just to make sure we can assess Steph's Finals performance correctly. Let's take 2 superstars who won a Finals in 5 games. Player X stats. Player Y stats. Who would you rather have? By the way, Player X is Kobe Bryant when he won the 2009 Finals MVP, and Player Y is Steph, who did not win the 2017 Finals MVP. That's probably because of Kevin Durant, who dropped 35, 8, and 5 on 55% shooting from the field, 47 from downtown. Yeah, I'm not mad at this one at all. Go ahead, KD. By the 2018 Finals, the story of Steph Curry's inability to take the Finals MVP had taken on a narrative of its own. When he was asked how it felt to have all the accolades except for the Finals MVP, he responded with a view of the bigger picture, literally saying, "Who cares?" The Warriors got their first sweep of the Finals in 2018, and Curry had a monster series, averaging 27 points, 6 rebounds, and nearly 7 assists. He even set the record for the most 3-pointers in a Finals game when he drilled 9 triples on Cleveland. But his homie Kevin Durant decided to go ahead and average a double-double for the sweep with nearly 29 points, almost 11 rebounds, and nearly 7 assists average per game, shooting a ridiculous 52% from the field. Yeah, that's pretty nasty. Steph got 4 Finals MVP votes, and KD got 7. After that series, the reigning 2-time Finals MVP Durant spoke up on the behalf of Curry, echoing the idea that when a team wins, the individual accolades don't really matter. That brings us to Steph's 5th Finals appearance in 2019, when the Warriors fell to the Raptors in 6 games. KD only played about 12 minutes that series with an Achilles injury, giving Steph a chance to take the spotlight. Unfortunately for the Dubs, the Raptors were the more complete team as injuries racked Golden State and Toronto took it over. But it wasn't for lack of effort from Steph, as he averaged 30 points, 5 boards, 6 dimes, on 41% shooting from the field. He even scored the 8th most points in a single finals game in NBA history, dropping 47 in the Warriors' Game 3 loss. But since the Warriors were unable to prevail, Steph Curry's trophy case collects more dust in the empty space where the finals MVP would go. So, to sum it up, that's 5 finals for Steph, with 3 victories and 2 surefire arguments that he could have been awarded the finals MVP in 2015 and 2017, maybe? I don't know, KD was killing. But if we look at the totality of his finals career, how do we view his numbers? Let's compare that to the Black Mamba's numbers over 7 NBA finals. He went 5-2 in the finals with 2 finals MVPs. If Curry is fortunate to make it back to the grandest stage, we'll see if he can pad his already impressive resume and add the elusive Finals MVP trophy. But at the end of the day, he's made it clear that helping his team win the championship is a much larger priority than any MVP trophy. His numbers prove that he's easily one of the greatest Finals performers of all time. And if the Warriors are winning, to echo Steph Curry, who cares who wins the Finals MVP?